हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट इम्पॉर्टेंट लाइंस ऑफ लैटिट्यूड। देर आर फाइव इम्पॉर्टेंट लाइंस ऑफ लैटिट्यूड: इक्वेटर, ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर, ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉर्न, आर्कटिक सर्कल एंड अंटार्कटिक सर्कल। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद इक्वेटर। इक्वेटर इज द लार्जेस्ट लाइन ऑफ लैटिट्यूड। इट डिवाइड्स आर अर्थ इंटू टू इक्वल हाफ्स: अपवर्ड नॉर्दर्न हेमिस्फीयर एंड डाउनवर्ड सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर। नाउ कम टू द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर। ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर लाइज एट 223.5 डिग्री नॉर्थ। हेयर इट इज रिटन 23.5। यू कैन राइट 23.5 डिग्री। एज यू नो 0.5 मीन्स हाफ। You can write in this manner also, and you can write 23.5 degree. Both are same. Now, our next latitude is Tropic of Capricorn. It is lies at 23.5 degree south. And next latitude is Arctic Circle. It lies at 66.5 degree north. And our next latitude is Antarctic Circle. It is lies at 66.5 degree south. And this is our North Pole, and downward our South Pole. Now students, you can see here, N is written with the degrees, like 23.5 degree and this N. Do you know why N is written here? Yes, student. As you know, equator is located at 0 degree, and it is divided our Earth into two equal halves. And those latitudes are located in the northern hemisphere are indicated with N. It means these are located in northern hemisphere. And see in this part, it is written S with the degrees. Here, it is written S. Why S is written here? Because these latitudes are located in the southern part. That's why it is written S. Students, now we will learn about heat zones. We can divide globe into three climatic heat zones on the basis of difference in temperature and rainfall. As you know, our Earth receives difference rainfall, temperature and sun rays, amount of sun rays. That's why it is divided into three climatic zones. Now come to the torrid zone. This is torrid zone. Torrid zone is lies in between Tropic of Cancer 23.5 degree north and in the south Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 degree south. The area lies in between is known as torrid zone. It is also called hottest zone because it receives vertical sun rays. That's why it is too hot and it's very difficult to survive here. Now come to the north temperate zone. The area that is lies in between Arctic Circle 66.5 degree north and Tropic of Cancer 23.5 degree north is known as North Temperate Zone. This zone is suitable for living organisms to survive because it receives slanting sun rays, and climate is here moderate. Moderate means not too hot, not too cold. Means you can find here more population and vegetation. Now come to the south temperate zone. It lies in between Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 degrees south and Antarctic Circle 66.5 degrees south. Means the area that lies in between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle is known as South Temperate Zone. Now come to the Frigid Zone. This zone is lies in near the North Pole. It is the North Frigid Zone. It is lies in between 66.5 degrees north and North Pole, and 66.5 degrees south and South Pole. This is the coldest zone because it receives very less amount of sun rays and it is covered throughout the year with snow. And amazing facts is here, it receives sun rays only for 6 months, continuous here day and next. Now students, we will learn about longitudes. Longitudes are imaginary semicircular lines running from North Pole to South Pole. As you can see from here, these are semicircular line, means half these are in the form of half circle. These are running from the North Pole to South Pole. These are imaginary line. You can't find these type of lines on the surface of Earth because it is drawn to the to find accurate location on the globe or on the map. These lines are called meridians or longitudes. These lines, there are 360 meridians and all of them are equal of length. All meridians are 360 and these are of equal length. You can see on the globe, these all are of equal length. The longitude that passed through Green Bridge near London is marked at 0 degree and is called the prime meridian. Yes, Greenwich, student, Greenwich is a place. It is located in London, and which meridian passes through Greenwich is known as prime meridian, and it is marked as 0 degree. Now, the other meridian that lie east and west of prime meridian, means you can see this dotted line, it is known as prime meridian. It passes through Greenwich in London, and some other meridian are lies east of the prime meridian and west of the prime meridian. Total, you can see here, east of the prime meridian there are 180 and west of the prime meridian there are 180. Means total total meridians are 360. These divide the globe into the eastern and western hemisphere. Students, you can see here, this is our prime meridian that is marked at 0 degree, and it is divided our globe into two equal parts. This part is known as western hemisphere and this east part is known as eastern hemisphere. Now just see our location of our now see in this map, this dotted horizontal line is known as equator. It is marked at 0 degree and it is divided our earth into two equal halves, upper one northern hemisphere and down one southern hemisphere. Now seen in the map, this India when we consider latitudinal extent, we find India lies in the northern hemisphere. Now come to the longitudinal extent. This is our prime meridian. It is also divided our globe into two equal halves. This part is known as eastern hemisphere and this part is known as western hemisphere. Now see, our India lies in the eastern hemisphere. Means our India lies in the north and eastern hemisphere. Means India lies in the northeastern hemisphere. Now, next point is the maximum distance between any two meridians is at the equator. The distance between any two meridian decreases as one move away from the equator. Just see, this is our equator line. When we consider two meridian, this, if we close to the equator, it distance between two meridians is larger. When we move towards the pole, it becomes narrow, it becomes smaller. Distance decreases as we move towards the pole. We can understand it for taking one example. Have you seen muskmelon? Yes, everybody like muskmelon. When we cut muskmelon, when we make slices of muskmelon, and we see that slices of muskmelon, it is broad in between, and when we go towards the end, it becomes narrow. In the same manner, when longitudes are more broad at near the equator, when we move towards the pole, its distance of the longitudes decreases. Now, meridians cross the parallels at the right angle, means at the 90 degree. As you can see here, these horizontal lines, these are latitudes, and these vertical lines, these are longitudes. And these longitudes are crossing the parallels, they are cutting the parallels at the right angle, at the 90 degree. Meridians help us to measure distance in the east-west direction. Now, come to the earth grid. What is earth grid? See in this picture, the parallel of latitudes and the lines of longitudes. These are latitudes, these all horizontal lines, these are known as latitudes, and these vertical lines, these are known as longitudes. These latitudes and longitudes intersect each other at the right angle and frame a network like structure, and this is called grid. The grid helps us to locate place on the globe or map. Thank you.